Rich Franklin's One Warrior series from you in Singapore today. Steve Dawson and Gianni Suba calling the shots.
Steve, I spoke to Viet yesterday and he said he wants to use his feints to set up his strikes. He says he also wants to showcase his grappling because he got a knockout in his last bout. So he wants to show Rich Franklin that he's capable in all areas.
See, there's a man who's thinking about it, thinking about how he can impress Rich, how he can get that ticket to the big time. It's not enough winning, isn't it? You've got to show that you've got the all-round game because you'll need it when you get to the big stage. So smart thinking.
Yeah, Viet An here shares a coach with Malaysian superstar Ev Ting. Time. Thank you for that, Steve. I apologize for
the wrong info. I didn't know the rule. I was just told by my producer. Left hand on. He looks strong, doesn't he, Singh?
Very strong.
Go win the leg.
Oh, the low leg kick takes the legs of Viet An Doe out. But now Viet with double underhooks. He's going to lift him. Wow. Nice show of athleticism by Singh. Oh, good scramble here. This is a great scrap.
Good knees, very, very energetic, Govindale. Viet An Doe there. Just happy to get out of that for a second, because he's very, very busy. Oh, good left hand from him. He walked into that.
It was a counter left. Cuts Link leaning in too much.
And he's going after it now, isn't he? He sees the opportunity. Knee to the body as well. And Doe suddenly has a little bit of daylight with which to work. And there's another big left hand. It's not a pretty shot that he throws. From an orthodox stance, it comes back quite a long way, but Govindale doesn't seem able to get out of range.
Beautiful level change by Doe to change things up.
Kayun making sure that nobody gains or loses an advantage.
Top control, putting forward pressure on Govin. Great job by Govin to stand back up.
This early Doe has got dangerous hands, hasn't he? That left hand is his big head kick. And the big head kick as well. And it's amazing to me that Govindale is still on his feet, but he isn't now. And it's all over. My goodness me, what a devastating finish that was. Viet An Doe says, it is finished, I'm done. 2-0 his professional record now. And Rich Franklin, sitting at ringside, has seen something special. It's all about that body of work, Gianni, isn't it? You've got to impress more than once.
But bang!
There's a good first start for you.
And here he finishes off with a hook, I think, Steve. Blue corner. Bang, that's it right there. Drops him and he just finishes off with right hands. Let's look at it again. Just a short little check hook. Cracks him right on the jaw.
Wow, really did drop him, didn't he? And Adam Kayum went sprinting in straight away because he knew we were just about done.
Winner, blue corner.
Wow, if we see a more devastating finish than that today, I can't wait to get there. Enjoying the action, but he's doing more than enjoying it. He's watching very, very carefully because he's the man that can award the contract for the big show. It's a busy start, isn't it, from Lee?
Steve, you can see the clear size advantage for Lee.
He's got very energetic movement. Hands moving, feet moving. The head, though, remarkably still.
Beautiful entry here, though, by the Jesus. Takes him down, by Lee. He's got to switch positions. All he needs to do is move his hips out and scoot his hips towards the Jesus.
The Jesus had his hands really tightly around the knees of his opponent. Wow. There, he's let go now and going for his back.
Good job by Lee to stop that. Mikhail's looking to take the back of Lee, but Lee prevented by using his left arm to stop his leg getting in.
Digging his back into that ring post so that his opponent can't squeeze in between them, although he's giving it a good shot, De Jesus.
Yeah, Lee's doing the right things. He's trying to go 2-on-1 on the hands to break the grip of De Jesus, but De Jesus is working hard here.
Looks handy, De Jesus, doesn't he?
Yeah, looks very slick on the ground. Lee needs to be careful here. Might get his arm locked up.
So he's got that right arm just looking for the throat, but he's got an arm in between.
Lee reversing the position with the potential takedown of his own.
Nice little game of chess going on in that corner.
Yeah, this is nice grappling. Beautiful grappling displayed by Lee and the Jesus.
And in comes some punches, couple of punches from Lee.
The Jesus is trying to work his way up with the underhook.
Sends in a little knee as well as they get to their feet. Strong day, Jesus, isn't he? Using all of his body weight and technique and balance.
Yeah, this is a battle in the clinch right now. Both men giving up position, exchanging position, dominant positions. Lee's going to look to dig his underhook in and lift the Jesus up.
Lee looks the stronger of the two. He looks bigger, doesn't he? But DeJesus giving it absolutely everything.
Yeah, DeJesus is just scrapping hard right now, going from position to position. That's what's making it so hard for Lee. When he has a strength advantage, but DeJesus is clearly faster.
His body shape is accounting for a lot of that strength. And by that, I mean the way he's angling into his opponent and giving himself a wide stance, making it very difficult for Lee to settle.
Yeah, Lee looking for the switch again. You see that left arm inside the leg of DeJesus? He's going to use that as leverage to pull his hips forward. And that puts a lot of pressure on the shoulder of DeJesus, preventing him from clasping his hands. But DeJesus looked for the back take earlier in the round. Let's see if he does that again.
He's got a long way to get around there. Again, using that ring post to sort of block that avenue.
Yeah, he's going to go for it again.
Oh, he's done it, though. Very sneaky, isn't he, the way he gets in. He's on one leg, though, at the moment.
He's okay here. He's going to move his left arm across his body. He's going to end up on top. There you go. Good work by Lee. These guys just showcasing beautiful grappling. Lee with the offensive takedown now.
Yeah, it's fascinating stuff to watch this. .137 left in this opening round, much of which has been on the deck, and fascinating to watch as these two exhibit strength and technique to see who can get into the better position. And it's been very neutral so far. Nobody's really, really got a hold of this one just yet.
Uh-oh, here Lee's controlling the arm. This is a bad spot for DeJesus. He's got his arm pinned. His back arm is trapped by Lee, and Lee's going to unload with some right hands here.
Yeah, that head is wide open to that right hand, isn't it?
Bad spot for DeJesus, but DeJesus works his way back up again.
Yeah, got his leg in the way, back up, using good leg strength. So DeJesus now with his back to his opponent. And what can he do from this standing position? Sweeps that left arm under his opponent's right.
Yeah, DeJesus wants to face Lee. Turn his hips into face Lee.
He's managed that very well. It was all to do with that left arm, sweeping Lee. His body around.
He's got his hand clasp again. No, no, not yet.
Both looking for the trip. Watch the sweeping going on. See if they can just take one leg from underneath the body.
These are just incredible grappling exchanges going on. Look at that. Takedown back into the sweep, back into another takedown.
Very nice change of body weight there from Lee. Final moments of this opening round then. It's been an enthralling one, hasn't it? You can't take your eyes off this one. There's the man that Gianni thinks has a slight advantage at the moment. That can be wiped out within just a few seconds. Let's see how this goes. Good fast start from Lee. He started the first round very energetically, but this time he's executing with punches and kicks. Oh, nice work from Lee. Very busy, constantly moving target. And DeJesus matching him there for a while. But now he's back in this position where he's using his body shape to just convert all the weight he has into his opponent, pinning him to that corner.
Yeah, you can tell DeJesus is just very strong in the upper body, very well built in the back. He probably has a very strong grip. That's why he's been able to compete with the bigger, stronger Lee.
And he's still on one leg, but manages with his strength to keep tremendous balance, but eventually gets taken down. DeJesus will just not let go, will he? Lee being told not to lean on the rope takes a bit of punishment from the referee, and again, a little slapping motion. He's got two men to fight in there.
DeJesus trying to get to the back of Lee again, but Lee's preventing it. Look at every time The Jesus has his back, he turns in on him.
Oh, knee to the head. Pretty sure that landed. Our camera just changed at the point of impact.
Look at the transition. Lee goes to defend and Jesus switches to a single right away. These guys just outstanding grappling.
Hammer blows to the side of the head there from Lee as he gets driven back towards the corner. What power from DeJesus. Tremendous strength up from his knees to his feet. But then Lee comes back and pounds his man into the ring post once more.
DeJesus expending a lot of energy, Steve.
And he gets dumped in the process. This is a big energy expending contest, isn't it? We're at the 7 minute mark, just beyond, and these two are going to find it very tough to get to the end of this one with the freshness that they have now.
He has some good shots on top by Lee. Hammer fist and hooks.
Lee's corner man right next to him, guiding him through each step. No need for him to shout, and he's not. Much of this, Gianni, when your corner man is talking. So they re-establish position in the center of the ring so as not to be confounded by those ropes around the outside. So with space to work, Lee on top.
The Jesus is looking to use his butterfly hooks to sweep Lee. No, Lee passes to inside control. Good pass by Lee.
He has to be careful about those shots to the back of the head. DeJesus again exhibits wonderful strength in the legs to get up there from that position. Dumped again though by Lee.
DeJesus attempted a guillotine, but Lee popped his head right out.
As our referee repositions them in the center of the ring once again. Oh, big heavy blows coming from a long way back there from Lee. I think DeJesus did quite well just to move his head slightly and not take the full brunt of those. Look at the power, that driving power. He's very effective in that position.
Yeah, he looks very, very strong. But again, Lee has just been able to stop every attempt of DeJesus.
Does a good job of sprawling as well, doesn't he?
And then go into attack of his own.
Yeah. Oh, dumped not for the first time.
Stop. Disadvantage. He's doing really well. He's competing right now against Chang Ho Lee. But maybe I'd like to see him compete in a division that is his own, where he can be more effective and weight and strength wouldn't be as much of a factor.
Right now, his strength is coming from his technique, isn't it? The way he puts himself at a 45-degree angle, pressing his opponent into the corner post there. But it's a different world for him at the moment, on the deck with his back to his opponent.
DeJesus has his wrist trapped. Bad spot for DeJesus.
Yeah, this is the worst spot he's been in. We know he's got good strength to maybe get out of it. But he'll need a lot of it here.
Against a stronger lead, this is a terrible position for DeJesus to be in.
Head's taking a lot of punishment, punches coming in from all sides. The only thing that can save him now is the bell for the end of the second round, and that's gonna come in a matter of seconds. Blows to the back of the head quite correctly, pointed out by the referee.
But DeJesus is very slick. He can somehow get to the back of Lee and neutralize their strength.
He certainly showed signs of being able to do that in the first round. But the worm has turned. It was a good second round for Lee.
Oh, head kick by Lee.
Solid connection as well. Skips out of the way effortlessly, and DeJesus is in a little bit of trouble there.
DeJesus is fatigued right now. He's gassed. He put in a lot of energy in the first second round. Driving forward, but now he's in deep bad trouble, Steve.
Yeah, dumped once again, and he's taking forearms and fists to the head. Lee now has his back. But he's such a wriggler, isn't he, DeJesus? He won't give up that position that you really want, where you're full on with the back.
Yeah, DeJesus is so tough. Still battling in all these positions, not giving up, but Lee just looks like the strength advantage is gonna be too much for him.
Took a big right hand there, DeJesus, on the deck. And really, this bout is being dictated by Lee. Oh my goodness. DeJesus looks as if he's just about had enough, but he won't give up yet. We've seen he's tremendously tenacious. He'll be going right the way to the end, but sometimes size and strength is a very material factor, and I think that's what's coming into play here.
Top control by Lee, landing some ground and pound. DeGees is just a little bit slower now here in the third round.
Yeah, I think that size advantage is really starting to tell now, Gianni. Just over 3 minutes left.
Lee's looking for Americana.
Yes, he is. That arm looks as if it's moving towards an unnatural position.
DeGees is going to be okay here. He's going to turn in, get his elbow free. But now Lee comes up on top. This is not where he wants to be. If Lee flattens him out right now, this will be the end.
So he's got his back. He's flattened out, as you say.
This might be it.
Tremendous tenacity, though, from DeGees to keep trying to arch that back. There it is again. Try and make things difficult, but he's taking an awful lot of punishment.
Trouble here.
The referee may not wait too much longer, Gianni, and there it is. He's called it. 2:31 left of the final round, and there's the elation from the Korean. It was a deserved win. It was a journey, though, wasn't it? It was tough at the beginning, and he had to work his way through that. In the end, size and strength told. A good effort, wasn't it, from Mikhail DeJesus? But the bigger man won and advances his professional record now to 5-0.
Yeah, here's the finisher. Lee flattens him out. So much weight on his back. DeJesus got nowhere to go. Again, flattens him out. Ground and pound. The referee has no choice but to step in and stop this bout. Great job by Tae Chang Ho Lee to secure that win.
Great effort by both men, really.
Steve, I'm very excited for this one. Both these women, so talented. Kristy Obst coming off a TKO victory here in One Warrior Series. Wen Ha as well has been showing a lot of progression.
Yeah, we've seen these two before and we've really enjoyed their contests. They give everything.
Faints early by Obst. Trying to draw a reaction from Wen.
Southpaw, Obst, she's got long arms as you can see, and she'll give it a couple of shots if she misses with that big left.
Yeah, Obst is reaching a little bit too much right now. She needs to be patient.
Wen Ha, clearly the shorter woman, shorter arms. She's got to get inside that long reach and do some damage. She'll work the counter. That's what. That's what she's likely to try and do. There's a mark on Wen Ha's nose there from that sort of prodding right jab, I suspect. And she takes a big left hand as well. So good work from Obst. She's picking her opponent off with an economy of effort.
Yeah, straight lefts by Obst and going through. Wendell, very patient.
Nice left hand from Obst again.
Oh, he's gonna finish his takedown, but good sweep by Obst, using the momentum by Ha.
Keep the hips, keep the hips. Yeah, let her up. Perfect whip.
Obst got the call from her corner to let Wen Ha up to her feet there.
I want you to hit that body, Win. Hit that body.
Obviously comfortable in the stand-up position, not wanting to mess about on the deck.
Yeah, Wen Ha trains out at Tiger Muay Thai with the Hickman brothers, George and Frank. So you know she's well-versed in the grappling department.
But also, Obst got those long arms. You figure that standing up, that's where her advantage is.
Yeah, she's using the straight left hand, Gianni.
And Wen Ha takes a good shot. We've seen that before from her. Got a good, solid chin.
Wen Ha's got double unders, hands clasped. If she can lift her hip. No, Obst has the underhook now. Obst might come out the back here.
Obst bringing up that left knee as well. There it is again. She tucks that chin in nice and tight, Obst, doesn't she? Very, very difficult for Wen Ha to land a decent blow.
That was a beautiful feint by Obst as well. Lift up the knee to land a straight left.
That's a great left hand, and it's going to be finished. It was two superb left hands.
Wow.
From Kristy Obst, and it was a devastating finish. By the time Wen Ha went down, you knew it was over. The referee got there as quickly as he possibly could, but that was outstanding work from Kristy Obst.
Straight left, the left hands, that was a hook over there. Left hook, right hook, drops Wen Ha, and Obst just finishes the job.
Yes.
Yeah, I thought originally it was two left hands. There was the first.
The right one is the one that drops her,
yeah,
Steve.
Yeah, you're right. She missed with the follow-up left hand, but the first left hand was a really heavy blow. Classy stuff.
Yeah, great job going to the straight hand, and then switching it up with the hooks. Caught Wenha over the guard.
Ready? Choo!
And this could be the moment that determines his future in the ONE Championship circle. Rich Franklin, ringside, watching carefully. Luciano is in his second professional bout. He was a winner on his debut. And he'll be looking to take a giant leap via the stepping stone that Prates could be for him.
Yeah, Luciano might look new with 1-0 record, but he's had an extensive amateur career. This is a big step up for Luciano in the pro ranks. If he can take a win here over Prates, it would definitely put him in good stead.
Luciano, one of these athletes who has his feet nicely planted on the canvas, meaning that when he throws, it's going to be a solid blow. Prates is just prowling around the ring here, looking as if he's absolutely at home. Yeah, almost in slow motion.
You see the experience, Steve. That's just him being comfortable in there.
Oh, sinks in that little left hand from the southpaw stance.
Push him there. Go.
The feeling that Luciano is being a little bit cautious. He knows that there's something that can be unleashed that could be a little bit frightening.
Yeah, protesting, very patient. Luciano putting the pressure on him. It seems to me that he wants to look for a takedown on Prates.
Up and down.
Continues to circle in a clockwise fashion. Prates just ducked under those punches with his right hand outstretched. Suddenly the attempt to the takedown. It's high though, around the waist. That's going
to
take a lot of strength.
Oh,
good reversal by Prates. Going to end up on top. Might take his back.
Oh, did very well. What are we seeing here, Gianni?
One hook in. Luciano not in trouble yet. But if Prates moves his butt backwards,
doesn't he
a bad spot?
Looks so calm. He was just nodding at his corner man.
Protect your arm. Protect that firearm when he slides.
Luciano in trouble here.
Luciano's okay here.
Movement.
Needs to get one of his legs free.
Good.
To remove one of the hooks of Prates. But now Prates with a body lock. Oh no. Luciano's gonna end up on top, but wow. Good scramble there. Prates was attacking the arm, but great job by Luciano. Move forward pressure and end up in guard.
Let's defend first. Defend the threat.
I can hear the corner men giving very clear advice.
Take your time. No desperation.
Luciano being told just to take things easy.
Take care of the legs.
Settle.
Extensive amateur career he may well have had, but this is, as you said, a big step up for him. But it's the opportunity, isn't it, of using Prates as a stepping stone to the big time, a shortcut, if you will.
You're exactly right, Steve. We talk about jumping over the ladder all the time. This is one of those bouts that will help Prates, excuse me, Luciano, jump that ladder.
Oh, what an opportunity.
Stay on the legs.
Back on their feet. Prates looks so, so comfortable.
90 seconds, son.
Minute and a half left in the opening round.
Go to that corner, Joey.
It feels like slow motion the way Prates moves, doesn't it? It's very, very deliberate.
Yeah, he's got Luciano on the back.
Oh, wow. Straight punches really took a toll on Luciano's head.
Keep going to the corner.
Prates cutting that ring off now, something he wasn't doing in the first part of this opening round. Nice left hand from Prates, and these punches are starting to come home now, and Luciano's starting to feel them. So he goes for the takedown to try and get some relief.
Prates gonna end up outside again. Stuffs the second attempt by Luciano.
Hands are up, Joey.
Oh!
Well, he went and back, did a backward roll, but managed to recover in time. Luciano a tad slow on picking up on that. He could have really taken advantage of it. But you don't want to fall into a trap that's full of a nest of vipers, do you? And that's what Prates could provide you with.
Yeah, Prates looks to have good Brazilian jiu-jitsu as well. Luciano hasn't been successful in his takedown attempts.
Final 10 seconds.
Reversed by Prates each time.
Brings that knee up, picks up a right hand on his way out, though. Oh. It says on his neck, we will see. Takes the center of the ring again. Luciano takes the outside.
Corner.
Oh, what a straight jab that was.
You've seen that Prates the one putting the pressure on Luciano.
These straight punches are damaging, though, Gianni. The right jab, the left that comes from much further back from that southpaw stance. And he's got a wide stance, Luciano. Those gloves not too tightly held together in front of his face, and he's being punished because of it.
Don't stay in that line.
Yeah, you can tell Luciano's the one forcing it, was Prates inching his way into his openings, looking for the holes.
A little bit of his hand bandages coming undone within the glove there that the referee might see too shortly.
Prates looks to want to attack the body with that left kick.
Loving that jab, Gianni, straight through the guard. It is quite a porous guard, though, isn't it? He's really not bringing those hands together. When you consider the amount of punches that are coming in straight down Broadway, they're not arcing punches, these. There's another one, the big left hand. Comes back with a nice jab of his own, though, Luciano.
Yeah, Prates' straight shots are starting to get through, Steve. Luciano's coming back with shots of his own.
Looking for the big right as well.
Another attempt. Another attempt stopped by Prates.
He's got some strength, Prates, hasn't he?
Yeah, it's technique as well, Steve. Straight left.
It's all about these straight punches. Scoring well, but they're also going to hurt, and they may cause some damage soon. We're not even halfway through this bout. There we see it again. Right and a left.
Yeah, there you go. Prates going to look to go back to the kicks now. He knows he's got Luciano hurt with the hands.
Got to do something, Luciano, because he's being picked off.
Luciano just forcing it a little bit, Steve. He needs to work off the front hand. You go back to the kicks.
Well, that was a nice little lead uppercut from Luciano. It's a punch you don't often see.
Prates is playing those mental games. Hit him with a shot, opened up a little cup, and just tells him, hey,
yeah,
that shot landed.
Little cut underneath Luciano's left eye. I think you can all see it. Not the worst place it could be. There's going to be no trouble of the blood running into the eye and compromising the vision, but nonetheless, it's another target for Prates to aim for.
This is just the experience of Prates coming through. Going to the body, playing these mind games. Luciano forced to throw shots that he doesn't want to throw, just like that, Steve.
Yeah, overhand right that looked wild, a little bit ugly.
Oh,
that slapping noise reverberating around the arena here in Singapore in this wonderful studio setting that we have for One Warrior Series events.
Luciano's gonna attack that body again.
Right and left from Prates, and they landed right on the button, both of them. Left hand again, right on that cut.
90 seconds.
Minute and a half left in the second round.
Luciano's starting to look a little desperate, Steve.
He is, and has Prates got the appetite to finish it here and now? I'm sure he's got the patience to take it into a third round where Luciano will be likely even more tired.
Prates just too slick with his takedown defense. Luciano getting in on the shots but just unable to finish.
I know that Rich Franklin was impressed with Luciano's composure in the ring, but if we're comparing the two, how much composure does Prates show for us here?
Just unbelievable. It's the amount of experience he's had with the stand-up Muay Thai, with his grappling and MMA as well.
And you want to see this guy competing with the best, don't you?
You do. And if he can impressively defeat Luciano today, he might be one step towards that. Prates inching forward now.
Oh, super left hand. And he just picked it off one shot. Didn't even set it up. At will. That's the nature of Prates' attack now. Oh, and the big jumping knee in Luciano. I thought for a moment was going to go down.
Luciano threw a spinning elbow in return.
Seconds are running out in this second stanza. And it looks like we'll have a third round, and I'm all for that because I'm absolutely loving watching Prates.
Prates is picking him apart, Steve.
So he's got 5 minutes to show us whether he can just raise it a level more, Prates, and stop his opponent here. But Luciano, well, don't discount him yet. There's that big swinging overhand right. Don't think it landed, but it's a warning shot across the bows.
He needs to set it up, Steve. Go to the jab, go to the leg kicks.
Wow. He brings that leg up to the head so quickly, and it's seamless. He doesn't seem to set himself up for it.
Up and down, up and down.
Oh! Suck it tight. Throws a head kick up as Luciano tries to shoot.
There you go, head pressure.
Again with that reversal.
Press in again, press in again. Press it again.
Looks so relaxed, arms down by his sides. What's Luciano got for us with 4 minutes left?
Press.
What's he got? How can he turn this around?
Press. Come on.
Even Prates will tire despite his wonderful economy of effort.
To the corner, you're waiting, you stand in the center. Oh!
Spinning back kick seemed to land right on the button to me, and if it did, how did Luciano stay on his feet?
Luciano showing a good beard, taking that shot. Prates controlling the front of Luciano.
Right hand.
Prates pouring it on Luciano now in the third and final round.
Arms down by his sides now. He's so confident that he has the measure of his man that he can sway out of range.
On the feet, Prates just has way too much in his arsenal for Luciano.
Luciano needs
another jumping knee, just pulling out everything today, Prates.
Seems to have it all, doesn't he? Providing us with an exhibition in the first 2 minutes of this final round, showcasing all of his talents. And there's one very important man watching who's very keen to see all of that, and that's Rich Franklin, whose name is lent to this series, where we pick out up-and-coming athletes to take to the big time. And that is exactly what Carlos Prates is looking at now.
Yeah, Luciano's still not out of it, though. 2 minutes and a half left. If he can string a combination together to get the respect of Prates, he can look for the shot, maybe look for a submission. But on the feet, Prates just too slick for him.
Still seems strong, Luciano, but he just took another couple of punches to the head that sent him a step back. Strong, but perhaps slightly more ragged now than he was at the start of the contest. Prates still seems to have that oily slickness to his moves, but that was a good left hand that sent Prates' head rocking backwards. Doesn't seem bothered by it at all. Stalking his man now. 150 left. Can he finish it? Oh, my. What a jaw Luciano has. How does he stand up to this?
Up and down, up and down.
A spinning heel kick into the 1-2. Just Carlos Prates putting on a show today.
Center.
I'm not even sure he wants to stop this one inside the distance. I think he just wants to showcase every move he's got. Luciano now cut above and below the eye. He's enjoying himself, Gianni, isn't he?
Yeah, he's just toying with him right now. On the feet, throwing his everything. Spinning kicks, knees, crosses, low kicks. Whatever you want, Prates got it for you.
Right, left, straight punches from beginning to end. That's been his big weapon. And Luciano gives him a little nod there of appreciation. And Prates taps his gloves. I think both men know the destination of this contest.
Yeah, Luciano just outgunned on the feet today. Prates just got too many tools for him. Great effort by Luciano. But the difference is that, Steve, Luciano is loading up on his shots, whereas Prates is picking up his shots. He's setting them up, going to the leg. And you see he's gonna go to the hands now.
He can get inside with those straight punches and then just lean away from the counter. It's wonderful to watch. It's high-level stuff. and enjoy it while you can, because there's only 15 seconds left.
Up, up. You good?
There's the sportsmanship, the honor that we see consistently in the One Championship circle, in the One Warrior Series ring.
Yeah, Prates is probably going to circle away.
Time.
Just a respectful thing to do. Great performance here by Prates.
You said it, and I think we can see a little collection of some of the gymnastics that he provided for us.
Spinning back kick. This is a right downwards elbow. Just whatever you wanted. High kick into the 1-2, cracks Luciano on the jaw. And here's the spinning heel kick into the 1-2 as well. Bang! Luciano just outgunned on the feet today.
What an athlete. How much longer can it be before we see him in the big show? Right. Surely not too long.
Fighters.
It all begins with his arm being raised today. And then Rich Franklin has some decisions to make.
Winner.
There it is. Seemed like the obvious decision. The matchmaker, Bashir Ahmad and Rich Franklin, had their Instagrams almost crashed. Such was the response to seeing these two in the ring together. And we're about to enjoy the fruits of that match right now.
Ali Motamed in his last bout against Zach Lang was able to stop the takedowns. Can he do that against Yoshino? Stops the first one.
Tough time stopping the second one. Gets that leg up there. Look how composed Yoshino is. Just had a big foot swing past his face and didn't seem bothered by it at all. What a huge coming together that was.
Yoshino stalking Motamed.
Motamed, pincer movements around the ring. Unleashing that big kick. It's a big, big kick, isn't it? It's got a great big arc to it.
Beautiful toss. Outside trip by Yoshino. Takes Motamed down.
Very strong, isn't he?
This was the judo we were talking about. He showcased this in Japan and he's showcasing it again here in Singapore.
It almost seems as if Motamed is a weight division bigger. He's tall, he's rangy, but Yoshino is very strong.
Yeah. Motamed uses that strength to help him get back up to the striking positions. But Yoshino, very experienced on the ground, is going to use that to, against his will, to pass.
Watch out your head, guys.
And their heads right in our camera here. 3.5 minutes left in the opening round.
Yoshino taking his time, digging those knees into the body of Motamed.
Almost forgetting that his right arm was in the way. He almost hit himself in the arm there with that knee.
Yoshino with his knee on the belly now. He's going to look to attack that left arm of Motamed. Motamed needs to watch out.
Good strong work from Motamed, though, showing good core strength, but he's taking a bit of a beating. Again, those punches coming from way back from Yoshino. So Motamed pulls him in, try and cut that distance down, reduce the space in which his opponent can work.
Yeah, you see, Motamed is so dangerous. He's had so many bouts where he's losing the bout and just throws a knee or a strike or an elbow that ends the bout. So don't count Ali Motamed out. But right now, it's all top control by Yoshino. Ali Motamed trying to get his legs free, takes a couple shots. For his work.
Motamed getting his knees in between his own body and his opponent just to try and prevent those long arcing punches from landing effectively. Working hard, listen to how heavily they're breathing, how tough it is there. These two athletes coping with blows and the body weight of their opponent being maximized with balance and positioning to make it as uncomfortable for the man with his back to the ground as possible.
Yoshino with the underhook here might slide his knee and pass. Slide that left leg of his through.
Motamed
is trying to stop that.
So that left leg is all tied up there.
Yeah, that's why Yoshino is throwing these short little shots. He wants to open the guard.
Motamed spins round and ups, gets to his feet.
And another entry by Yoshino. Right away goes to work. Inside trip. Outstanding grappling by Yoshino. Motamed, though, so slick. Always working to get back up. He's not giving Yoshino any chance for him to secure a position.
Little cut on the inside of his nose, just towards the right eye there. Nothing too damaging at this stage, certainly.
I'm seeing.
55 seconds left of the opening round.
Yoshino in half guard again.
1 minute, Ali, 1 minute.
Stop, choke!
So he's still got that left leg locked in the figure four.
Watch out, back of the head.
Yoshino looking to isolate that arm, Steve.
What's he going to do with it?
He needs to step his leg over to attack a Kimura or armbar. Doesn't have the Kimura grip. But you know Ali Motamed knows this. He recognizes it and wants to keep his back flat to prevent himself from getting turned.
And he's so strong as well, isn't he? Wonderful core strength.
With both hands. Oh, hammer fist.
They were big, weren't they? They're coming down now, and he's having to protect himself with that open palm and now grasp the left hand of his opponent to stop those damaging punches raining down. Final few seconds of this opening round. Strikes to the back of the head and the spine are illegal blows. Wow, a nasty coming together of shins there at the beginning of the second round.
Nice, there you go, keep him on the side. More feints. Keep him on the side.
There's that slapping sound again. You really feel as if you're in there with them, don't you?
Yeah, like I said, Steve, don't count Ali Motamed out. He's dangerous from the first minute to the last minute.
For sure, he's
looking for the finish at every second.
A very, very different opponent than last time out when he took on Zach Lang.
Yoshino just coming forward. He's stalking him, not giving him any space to throw his kicks.
Zach Lang really laid back, very sort of fluid, easygoing, effective. But Yoshino is just a bundle of energy in front of him.
Yeah, he's like a bulldozer coming straight at Ali Motamed.
Guys, stop!
To try and be re-established in a slightly more advantageous position than you were in when the action was stopped. But the referee's on top of that.
Back on the head, watch out.
Cross, one of the premier referees in the game. Not going to allow that today.
One bump, underhook.
Bump. Yoshino hands clasped. Going to look to pass to the left again. This is a battle here. Motamed preventing Yoshino passing.
He's got his head really low, Yoshino. Just trying to disturb Motamed.
Yeah, the head keeps Motamed's hips flat as well.
It discombobulates him in all manner of ways.
Good job by Ali to get free, create some space. But Yoshino with control on the leg, he's not going to let him up. Don't expect Yoshino to let Ali Motamed up here.
Holding the right ankle and kicking him on the backside four times now.
Yoshino, if he doesn't advance here, referee Olivia Cost might break him up.
Oh, swept the leg aside and came down with a huge left hand. I'm not sure that it landed flush. He may have just been able to move his head to one side to make it a glancing blow or even get a glove in between them there. But
that was
looked enormous,
left,
didn't it?
Steve, yeah. But now here, Yoshino's going to look to push on the leg of Ali Motamed and step over, look for it.
There's an ear injury for Yoshino. Those ears look as if they've taken a bit of a battering over the years anyway, but there's a...
Yeah, you see Ali Motamed targeting it too. He's a scrapper, Ali Motamed. He finds ways to win.
Keep smacking him harder, comes the call from the corner men. Now that's that left ear that's causing Yoshino a little bit of trouble. Ever seen a contest stopped because of a cut to the ear? I mean,
I have
depends how damaged the tear is or whatever.
Yeah, I have. It depends on the severity of the cut. Sometimes if a cut on the ear is too big, you would have to stop the contest.
Yeah, we're talking about an external organ, basically. So there can be tears and all sorts of things that lead to a stoppage. So Olivier Costa, I'm sure, will look very closely at that. 1:45 left until his cornermen will get the chance to examine it.
Yoshino now needs to pass. He cannot stay in guard now. because he has an open ear here, and those short little shots will just continue being damaged.
So something for Motamed to aim for, to work with. At the moment, though, back to the canvas, and Yoshino continuing to apply the pressure.
Yes. Top control by Yoshino, Steve. Ali Motamed throwing these shots to the ear, causing a little bit of damage. But
oh, no. No, straight back onto the breach. So a minute or so left. Yoshino straight back into it.
Outside trip again. Wow.
And Motamed almost finds himself entirely out of the ring there.
Yoshino looks for the outside trip again. For the first time, you see Yoshino slowing down, not closing the range as much.
Curious assault by Yoshino. Oh, good left hand from him, but Motamed will not be moved. Look at how hard he's breathing, though. It's been very, very hard work for him.
Yoshino as well, with his hands right on his waist, so low.
Yoshino getting that kick right up there to the jaw. What an athlete he is. Takes a good right hand, though, from Ali Motamed. And these two absolutely slugging it out in the final seconds of this second round.
Grabbing at it. Probably discomforting, but Steve, are we looking at a change in tide? Is Ali Motamed going to land these hard shots in the third and final round?
Well, he has to do it now.
He has to do it right now. You stay on him, Ali.
Pressure him. Judges will look at this contest in its entirety.
Stay inside.
So they won't judge it round by round. They'll look at the whole 15 minutes to judge who the winner is. And Yoshino, the man who's been applying the pressure, you would feel Gianni is probably in front.
Yeah, it completes another takedown. This was a crucial takedown.
Can he get the back of his opponent? It's very difficult to do with Ali Motamed.
Make him pay for those.
Oh, nice little sweep.
So tricky is Yoshino, but now he's got both hooks in.
Butt up.
Oh, no, one hook in,
the other one.
Ali Motamed is going to pop out.
Oh, he's done well to get out of that. It did look as if it was both hooks for a while. Right and a left, though, from Motamed.
Yoshino needs to keep his hands up. This is the time for Motamed to land his strikes. This is a dangerous game for Yoshino.
Desperate times call for desperate measures. He's got a huge following in Iran. They'll all be watching very closely and hoping that in this last 3.5 minutes he can turn this one around. Ali Motamed still light on his feet, Gianni. But the fury of the man in front of him is just unrelenting.
Unrelenting is the word, Steve. Goes back to his shot again to neutralize the attack of Motamed.
He's gonna hold you there. He's got nothing. He's just gonna hold hitting him. Make him there you go. Now up. Get your feet underneath. Up.
You see him trying to take away the arms of the post up, but Motamed's gonna pop back to his feet again. Motamed just refuses to stay down.
Getting a little bit ragdolled at some time.
Look at that.
Yoshino has tremendous strength, but that's a great effort from Motamed to pop back up. And they're on their feet again, where you figure Motamed might be able to do his best work. Bit of a wardrobe malfunction there. Olivier Cost took care of that.
Motamed just missed that right hand by inches, Steve.
And again, I would suggest centimeters perhaps that time.
Yeah, right now in this last part of the third round, if he lands a right hand like that, it's going to be damaging.
Yoshino walked into a knee to belly.
Hands low, Yoshino. Dangerous game.
Motamed's looking for that left-right, isn't he? That 1-2 that he hopes could make the difference. What a big bomb that was from Yoshino. Motamed ducked underneath it. Good thing for him as well.
Big right kick to the body.
It's a great effort from Yoshino, that injury to the ear, but he's shown tremendous strength. An absolute force of nature. He will not relent, will he?
But the same with Yoshino, goes to shot after shot. But now Ali Motamed is going to work his way back up again. Such a close contest, Steve.
Trying to pull those legs together so that there's no movement. no ability for Motamed.
Again, keep going.
Yoshino needs to climb up the body and pull Motamed out, but Motamed here is so tough.
You can see Wenhar in the corner there.
You got Trent Gurdum as well, Tiger Boy Thai.
Still bouncy, still on his feet, Yoshino. Still able to come at his man, but Yoshino is a man mounted.
Good job,
one that can move.
Oh,
left hand as he came in looking for a right. What an effort from Yoshino this is, from both men. 53 seconds left, that's all we've got.
This last 45 seconds is going to determine everything.
And Motamed knows that, and that's why he's throwing these big Hail Marys. But Yoshino, once he goes pressing for his man, it's very tough to just put him aside, to get rid of him.
Yeah, another takedown by Yoshino, but unable to secure the position. Ali Motamed pushing on the head, moving his hips. So hard to keep down Ali Motamed. Yoshino's getting these takedowns, Steve, but he's not doing anything significant.
Right to the body, left to the head, and that shook Yoshino a bit. And he took a knee to the head as well. What an effort from Ali Motamed in the dying moments of this contest. There's only 10 seconds left. Is it too little too late from him? That ear's looking pretty torrid in there, but I think time is just about elapsed. Let's have a look.
Winner.
It goes the other way. What an effort it was from him. What an effort from both men.